Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Demetra's Dishes. Today we're moving right along with the last and final menu of our Holiday Entertaining Made Easy series. We are going with holiday menu number 3. So you can use these menus for Thanksgiving, Christmas, or anything throughout this whole holiday season, or even if you're hosting a nice dinner party to celebrate something special. Today, I'm gonna teach you how to make my Greek style stuffed mushrooms. If you missed any of the other menus or any of these other recipes, I've shared so many since the beginning of the month, that might mean that you're not subscribed. So take a second to hit that subscribe button along with that notification bell so you don't miss any other recipes. These stuffed mushrooms are the perfect side to any holiday table. They're filled with feta and spinach. They're cheesy and oh so good. Let's go over the ingredients so we can get started. So over here, I have some portobello mushrooms. You could use whatever your favorite mushrooms are. Just make sure that you clean them well with a damp kitchen towel. Put them in a baking tray and go ahead and remove the stems. You could save the stems for soups and stocks. I have some mozzarella cheese. I have lots and lots of it. We're going to use just a little bit and I'm going to save the rest. I have some panko breadcrumbs, an egg, some dried oregano, salt, pepper, olive oil, crushed red pepper flakes, totally optional. If you like the heat, add them. If you don't, leave it out. Some sun-dried tomatoes that are packed in oil, 2 cloves of garlic, feta cheese, and some spinach. This is baby spinach. The filling is super simple to make. I'm just gonna finely chop this spinach. I'm using baby spinach, but use whatever spinach you can find. Just make sure to wash it well and to dry it well. I'm gonna add them to the big mixing bowl. I love the smoky, sweet flavor of sun-dried tomatoes, and I always buy them packed in olive oil. I feel like they're fresher that way, and they have less additives and things like that in there. Try to find something that's as pure as possible so that way you can keep it healthy. I'm just gonna finely chop the sun-dried tomatoes. I'm adding 2, but you could add as many as you like in there. Add those to the bowl. I'm gonna grate 2 garlic cloves. Crumble the feta cheese. I like to buy blocks of feta. I never buy already crumbled feta. I feel like it's too briny and it's not as good quality as the block is. It just takes a few seconds to just crumble this up. Now you can use the really good quality goat cheese feta, but I feel like in this recipe in particular, especially because it's mixed with other cheese and also so many other ingredients, you can definitely get away with a cow's milk feta, which is much less expensive. Next, I'm just gonna beat this egg before I add it to the mixture. A little bit of dried oregano, some freshly cracked black pepper, a little pinch of crushed red pepper flakes. I like the heat. If you don't like it, just leave them out. A little bit of salt. Those breadcrumbs are gonna need a little bit of salt, even though the cheese is in there and it's pretty salty and briny. What you can do is add the egg in the end, mix everything all together and give the mixture a taste and see if it needs any salt, you know, to begin with, and just salt it as you go. Then go ahead and make the egg be the last ingredient so that way you don't have to taste anything with raw egg in it. Next, I'm gonna add a big handful of shredded mozzarella cheese. I like to buy the big blocks of mozzarella and shred it myself. It's much more inexpensive that way and it lasts really long. As soon as you get the big block home, I like to buy mine in the big box stores like Costco. We have that here in America. I just cut it into smaller chunks and I put it in freezer safe bags and I store it in my freezer and it lasts forever. And then I just take one out at a time and I just shred it and, you know, use it as I need it. Now I'm gonna add about 2 tablespoons of olive oil and just a little bit of water. You can do water, vegetable broth, or chicken broth. It adds some moisture to the mixture. Just mix everything all together. And then once it's all mixed up, the filling is ready. So you can make this filling like about 1 or 2 days ahead of time and then just fill them the day that you're gonna be baking them. This filling is delicious. If you're not a fan of mushrooms, you can totally use this to fill other things, any other vegetables. You could do little tomatoes or bell peppers or anything you like. Get creative, let me know what you would use this in the comment section. I'd love to hear what you guys think. And that's it, the filling is ready to go. So I have a pound of portobello mushrooms that I'm using here, plus a little bit more. This looks like it was about 1.5 pounds, so I'm just using them all, but this recipe should fit them all. It should fill at least 1 pound. I'm just gonna fill the mushrooms now with this delicious filling. I like to really pack that filling in, put as much as fits in each one. So I'm done filling the mushrooms and I do have some extra filling left over. You are gonna have some extra filling left over. You could put in a little Ziploc bag and freeze it up to 1 month and use it at a later time. Or if you have some more mushrooms, go ahead and fill those. What I'm gonna do, I don't have any more mushrooms. So since I have 2 trays, a big tray of mushrooms and a small one, I'm just gonna put the leftover filling on the bottom of the smaller tray of mushrooms because we all love it. We don't have a problem with it. I wouldn't put it in the big tray because it does kind of look a little bit sloppy, but you do you and do it however you want to do it. This will also stay fresh in the refrigerator for about 3-4 more days, and you can use it anytime in that time period. I'm just gonna go ahead and bake it alongside that. Now I'm just gonna top them. Well, before I do that, I'm gonna drizzle a little bit more butter. Not butter, you can use butter. You can melt some butter and put butter on top of these, but I'm just gonna drizzle a little bit of olive oil over these mushrooms. And then I'm just gonna top them with some more mozzarella cheese. This is definitely one of those comforting, delicious sides. So I'm gonna cover the trays with aluminum foil. My oven is preheated to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm gonna pop these in the oven and I'm gonna let them bake for about 30 minutes covered and then 5 to 7 or 8 minutes uncovered until the cheese is nice and bubbly. I'm gonna show you what they look like as soon as they come out. But before I do that, I will also say that you can definitely fill these one day before, cover them with the foil and set it in your refrigerator and then just bake them off an hour before you're gonna serve them. That would work too. I'm gonna show you what mine look like as soon as they come out of the oven. So the mushrooms just came out of the oven. They look and smell amazing. I'm gonna go in and take a little taste. So delicious. The filling has cooked to a perfect consistency. It's cheesy. The spinach keeps everything nice and fresh and juicy tasting. The cheese is just amazing. The mushroom just cooked perfectly. It has such a nice meaty bite to it. It's so comforting, yet so simple to make. I think you guys are definitely gonna love this. The recipe is on the website, www.demetriasdishes.com. It's in the holiday menu number 3. Make sure you go on over, download it, subscribe if you haven't, thumbs up the video if you wanna see more like this, and I will see you guys next time. Yes, us.